You get more glory when you allow the Lord to take you through. And that's what we need to know and understand, the power of nevertheless. The power of nevertheless can be negative, or the power of nevertheless can bless you and give you miracles, or the power that we see right here with Jesus can take you through that hard place. And so now he comes back and he says to the disciples one more time, could you not tarry 1 hour? He said you need to pray, or you need to get up, lest you enter into temptation. Now what does that mean? You see what I'm going through? You're going to be tempted. And I want to know, tempted for what? Tempted to do what? But Jesus goes back and he prays again. And he came back for the second time. And he came for the third time. And he still tells them, you ought to pray. You ought to pray that you don't enter into temptation. But the last time he told them, take your sleep, take your rest, in other words. But here he was telling them that we need to pray because you're going to be tempted to do the wrong thing with the power that God is giving you. Because you think you ain't supposed to go do nothing. You're going to be tempted, and Satan is going to make you believe that this is not of God, but this is the works of the devil, and that nevertheless won't be for a positive thing from heaven, but you'll turn it into something negative. Now watch this, because the Bible says that Jesus came back, and Jesus said, nevertheless, not what I want, but what you say. And he says to his father, nevertheless, let your will be done. And he submitted and surrendered to God. He was not backing out. He was asking God, is there another way? The Bible says that he disrobed himself, Philippians says, of all his glory and became human just like us. It was the inner crucifixion. It was the knowing that he and his father would be separated. It was the knowing that he and his beloved disciples would be separated. But what gave him the words to know the power behind him, nevertheless, that the entire world could be saved.
Lord God.
Some of the things that we're asking God to take away is the thing that God wants to use to take you to another place. To bless more than just you. We're so selfish. We love ourselves. But let's talk about growth just for one more minute. We see in the life of Saul. And the Bible says, first of all, I don't know who would have chosen him, because he was a murderer and a liar. But those are the people that God can use.
Yes.
Right.
He said, I take the foolish things of the world to confound the
wise. Yeah, yes.
When I think about why Jesus chose me, I do know. Because I was one of those foolish things. But I thank God, like you, I'm on the other side. I thank God because of Jesus, nevertheless, I can experience grace. Because of his nevertheless, I can experience mercy. Because of his nevertheless, I stand here today, free, standing in the righteousness of Jesus Christ. But Paul says it this way. Paul went through some things, and Paul had went through so many things, and then he started hearing people complain about what they were going through. And Paul said, if you will allow me and my folly, y'all can brag about what you went through. You didn't go through anything. Because somebody spit in your face, somebody slapped you, somebody talked about you, somebody didn't give you your money. We use those kind of things. And Paul was saying, allow me and my folly. I don't have permission from God. God did not give me the permission, and I'm not using it for a brag. But let me tell you what going through really means. He said, I was beaten 3 times and thrown out of the city, and then I climbed back up on the wall and went back and finished preaching the gospel. Paul also said, I was beaten and thrown into a sink, hypothermia, and left for dead. He said, I can't even begin to tell you all the things that I went through. He said, I fasted often and prayed and beat with many of stripes. He said, but I went to the Lord, and he asked God, take this thing from me. And God would tell him, my grace is sufficient. But the Bible says he didn't go back twice. said, God, I thank you for the revelations.
Lord Jesus.
And every now and then, Paul says, when I get caught up, I beat myself under subjection. He said, I tell my flesh, shut up. And keep on going.
Yes.
I was listening to the song that they were singing. It talks about my soul deeper and deeper. The soul is mental asset. And we have to go deeper and deeper in God till it gets in your spirit. Mm-hmm. And once it gets in your spirit, there's no turning back. Mm-hmm. I want you to look at somebody and say, the power of nevertheless. I've been teaching this for a long time, so I had to combine it and do the best I can. But let me tell you, when you move from that place, wherever that place is you are, can't nobody tell you, can't nobody judge you, you know where you are. But I don't care where we are, there is another place.
Amen.
And when we get to that place where we can trust God with all that's within us, it's a place of spiritual growth. Then we get that nevertheless. And I believe in my heart that God has taken new and living way to another
place.
I believe that
Amen.
In my heart.
Amen.
Because if you go, they got to go.
Amen.
Amen. The oil runs down. It ran down. The Bible said Aaron's beard. It ran down. And if the anointing is running down, that means it has to get the body. And so I really received that thing last night in my spirit. That no, 40 means wilderness, but that's not for her. She paid the dues of the wilderness. She sacrificed those things already. She suffered many things, things you can't even tell nobody about, not even your best friend. Anybody know what I'm talking about?
Amen.
You ever been in a place you couldn't tell anybody?
Yes.
I love my honey. I love me some honey, but there's some things that I can't even tell him. One, the things of God are spiritually discerned. Mm. And I'm not saying he's not spiritual. I'm saying that's where he is. This is where I am. Sometimes people can talk you out of what God has for you by telling you, let's touch and agree and bind that thing up. But you need to be in a spiritual place and say, nevertheless.
Amen.
Nevertheless. It's not what I want, but you want. Don't let your negative nevertheless go out in the thing that God has promised you. Oh, forget about it. No. Because that's what they did in Egypt. And God told them for 40 more years, you're going to walk in the desert until every one of you out of a certain age is dead. And I'll take the next generation in there. Mm-hmm. Because you had a negative nevertheless. Mm-hmm. I know what you said, God, but it's bigger than us. And I come to tell you, if it's bigger than you, then it is good.
Mm-hmm.
If it's not bigger than you, then you're saying I can do it and you don't need God. Mm-hmm. But I promise you, it has to be so big till you can't even wrap your little carnal mind around it. Then nevertheless, where you have done something all your life for years and years and you think that that's all there is. Mm-hmm. We need another. Nevertheless,
yes.
According to your word, but by your word, I'm going to throw it out and do it again.
Yes.
And then there is the nevertheless of Jesus. Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, had a nevertheless. Not because he didn't want to do it, but because of the pain, the agony. He disrobed himself. He was a man just like you and I here in the earth. He had to come as a man because of what the first man, Adam, did. And the second man got it back. Mm-hmm. And so he says, nevertheless, Father. You know why I agonized over that thing? How in the world could he say, nevertheless? That I should go and die on the cross. He who knew no sin became sin for you and I. So we know what it's like to be under the pressure of sin. We know when we're wrong. We know what it feels like when we've done something wrong. But can you imagine just for a minute, if you can, the pain of sin for the entire world, not just then, but for ages to come. Not just for ages to come, but all those who were. He had all that poured out on him. Then the Bible Bible said he took his own blood in and offered it up unto his Father. His own blood. Because of his nevertheless prayer.
Amen.
Because of his nevertheless, we can stand on our feet and say, God, I thank you. We can stand on our feet and say, God,
I thank you.
I thank you.
The power of nevertheless. Don't be afraid. Use your faith and walk in that place that God has with you.
Yes.
The overseer, how do you know? You pray until you know. He said, there's nothing hidden that shall not be revealed. He said that I will show you great and mighty things, things that are fenced in. And the interpretation in the Hebrew scripture said, those things that are fenced in, God said, I'm going to reveal it to you. I'm going to show you. So that thing sometimes that we call the works of darkness, nothing but Satan. I'm sure Jesus could have said that. But Satan really wanted him to go to the cross. So we blame things on the devil and he says, no, I didn't want you to do it. I don't want you to do it. I don't want you to have that kind of nevertheless. But that kind of nevertheless is saying, God, I no longer tell you what to do. But I submit and I surrender. That kind of nevertheless is saying, God, I trust you. For your word says, trust in the Lord with all thine heart.
Hallelujah.
Lean not to your own understanding. But in every one of our ways, acknowledge him. That's how we do it. Acknowledge him. And he promised, I'm going to direct your path. Don't tell him which way we're going, but ask him. Is your will?
Oh,
or is this what I want? Is this taking me away from you or to you? Is this aborting the master plan or fulfilling?
Yeah.
We need to have those kind of prayers.
Help us, God.
So our prayer today is that we just submit and surrender because I know it's for this house. Is it a beat down? No, it's an elevation.
Amen.
It's a place where God wants us to go. And for those that love him and desire to be like him, just submit and surrender. We could just come up to the altar. We don't need no long prayer lines because I just don't do that. Make your way and make yourself a prayer. And just submit it to God. And I asked God. I really did. I cried out to God when I kept hearing that, nevertheless. I said, nevertheless what? But when I found out truth and the revelation of nevertheless, I promise you what I did was I fell on my face and I cried out to God. And I said, God, forgive me.
Lord Jesus.
Order him around like he's a Santa Claus or he's our servant.
Lord Jesus.
And all the things that I've been blessed in, what did I miss? Who did not get what God had for them because I chose the other way out with nevertheless?
Lord God.
Am I still wandering in the wilderness because I didn't have a positive nevertheless?
Lord God.
But I want the miracles of God.
Yes.
And the miracle only came. But nevertheless, at your word, I'm going to do it. Is there anybody else? We're not going to do a whole lot of praying. We want you to just come get to the altar as fast as you can and just ask God to take you to that place that he has ordained. There is another place. I don't care what anybody else thinks. I don't care where you think you are. There's still another place. There is a greater place than ever before. And I don't usually do this. I really don't. I always ask for those that don't know the Lord to come. Sometimes we know the Lord and sometimes we think we know the Lord. And we may know the Lord in some things, but we don't know the Lord in everything. And the only way to find out is to submit and to surrender to his will and his ways and his thoughts, and then allow him to direct us. I don't know about anybody else, but I don't like kids that just what you do with the first thing I gave you. That praying in the spirit is deep, crying out to deep, and Satan don't even know what you say. So he can't interfere. Holy Asatana Moonshot. Seal it if y'all show you. Well, I'm praying tongues. You should. But I don't sound like somebody else, you're not supposed to. There's too many different languages for us to be worried about who or what I sound like. The Bible said that's my spirit that's doing the praying. So let's just cry out to God for a few minutes and just give God that nevertheless. That nevertheless. I know what I asked you for, God, but now I have a nevertheless prayer. I have a nevertheless, not what I want, but what you want. Thank you, Father. We just thank you. We just bless you for who you are. We give you the glory for what you're doing in each and every one of our lives. We thank you for that place that you have ordained before the foundation of the world. Father, you know my heart. You know my heart, but you know it even better than I. For your word says that the heart is the most deceitful. You said out of our heart are the issues of life, God. Change my heart, oh God. Make it ever true. Change my heart, oh God. Make it more like you. And allow those issues to flow. But Father, give us a nevertheless prayer. Not our will, but yours. Raise us up to be spiritual giants. Help us to go into the world and declare and decree that they shall live and not die, to declare the works of the Lord. That they shall come to that place that you have ordained, knowing that you ordained purpose before they even messed up. Knowing that you ordained and had a master plan before the first temptation. And knowing that you're able and just to forgive all of our sins, their sins. God, we just thank you for the power. Nevertheless, we thank you for the revelations that's going to draw us even closer than we ever could imagine. God, we just thank you. Soria si kandura, yes. Shira no moshana nikondu. Hona na na nirbasata. Siyamandu na 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 lakiyamdu na 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 nas. When you are God, and these are your people, allow the greater to fall than ever before. Send us. Help us to go forth. The spirit of Elijah. Praying prayers that bring about you.
Yes, God.
Nevertheless, prayer that can change the conversation, the situation. Thank you as we yield ourselves to you. And we pray today that your kingdom will come in us. Your way of doing things, God. Your way of doing things. Forgive us for the abuse. Turn it around for use.
Yes.
To be used by you, God. To be used by you. And to everything that's contrary, we surrender, submit. And we ask for the blood of Jesus Christ that will eradicate everything. And today, there's no more I that live this life. Let it be Christ, the hope of glory. Speak, Lord. Speak, Lord. For your servant here. Thank you, Jesus.
Say yes by way of Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. prepare to eat this bread, to drink of this cup in acknowledgement that it pleased God, that in Christ should all of his fullness dwell, Lord God, that it pleased God to reconcile the world to himself through Christ Jesus, that it pleased God, hallelujah, it pleased God to make Christ Jesus a sufficient sacrifice for anything in us that would come up lacking or wanting. And so God, as we prepare to come to this communion table having received that word, we prepare to take of this cup and to take of this bread, Lord, acknowledging that in Christ Jesus, you've already given us everything that we need to say yes. In Christ Jesus, God, your word says that Christ Jesus is your yes and amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And as we eat this body and eat of this body and drink of this blood, may that be our yes and our amen. May it be our nevertheless in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah to your name, Lord God. I received of the Lord that which also was delivered unto me, that the Lord Jesus, on the night in which he was betrayed, took bread broken and said, this is my body which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. In the same manner, after he had supped, or after supper, he took the cup and said, this cup is the new covenant in my blood. Drink this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and you drink this cup, you do declare the Lord's death until he comes again. Hallelujah. As often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you do declare the Lord's death until he comes again. I want us to come eating and come drinking intentionally today, acknowledging that if God did not spare his son, won't he freely with him give us all things? Hallelujah. Amen. That's what the word of the Lord declares. Amen. That if raising Christ Jesus from the dead was not too much, hallelujah, if it wasn't too much, how might he be willing to show forth his power in your life and in mine? So I'm going to ask that all who are participating in communion would stand, amen, and face the center aisles, and I'll be down to serve. Thank you. Hallelujah.
Which is broken for
everything. Thank you, Lord.
And I can pray that we're there. There's no shedding of blood. There is no sending away of sin.
God, we thank you. Send away our sin.
So God, we thank you for his body broken.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you that he was wounded for our transgressions.
Yes.
He was bruised for our iniquities.
Yes.
The punishment that brought us peace
was laid upon him.
Yes. And with his stripes, we are healed.
Yes.
Now we're ready to go. In the same manner, he took the cup. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death. And all that it means,
amen,
every blood washed believer.
Hallelujah.
Until he comes again. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
This Patrick Hubs
said, I know it was the blood. I know it was the blood.
Thank you.
dismissed. Hallelujah. I give God praise for the word that we have received today. Hallelujah. Yes. Amen. Yes. If you weren't convinced that that was a word for us in this season, you ought to be convinced now. Amen. I don't know that I've ever been in church and the same message from the same passage. It was a different message, but the same message. Two Sundays in a row was preached, and I give God praise. Amen. I give God praise for being sure that we hear him. Amen.
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 Praise the Lord, everyone. So as we prepare to give, please remember that we still have our giving campaign going on. We have our black team, we have our red team. It is all towards our sound system. So if you would like to go on to newandlivingway.net and lwn.net, we have a portal where you can give online. If you click on giving, you will see that you will be able to click on the drop-down menu, give towards our offering. You can give your time, and you can also give to the giving campaign. Just choose black or red team as well. If you are not giving online, we have our envelopes in the back of our seat. You can take one of the manila envelopes, and you can simply write giving campaign on it, or you can place your tithe and your offering in there. We also have our white envelope for our speaker. Hallelujah. Pastor Shannon just talked about how this word is for us in this season. So if you would like to sow into that word, nevertheless, hallelujah.